Or we gonna try it again. And a little bit different camo this evening. Because this morning, I went to some public land and I had my hiking boots on because I thought I was going to be doing a pretty good bit of walking. Then my camera out here in these private fields that I've got permission for sent me a picture of a big strutter right out of the gate. Like, he had to have been roosted right on the edge of this field. So I rushed over here, not thinking about how wet the grass in these fields are in the morning. And I was soaked from my feet all the way up past my knees. And them clothes didn't dry out, so I had to change. So I'm kind of mix-matched here with the vest and the clothes. This field was full of turkeys yesterday evening, so we're gonna try to get up in here, try to lay eyes on a gobbler, work ourselves into a good position. So all we can do is try.
Okay, I've spotted two turkeys out here in this dip. I'm gonna try to get better positioning, but it'd be real easy for them to see me. I'm gonna have to stay as low as I possibly can. I need to get to these shadows and get out of the sunlight. Shoot. I can see him. I don't know if it's a gobbler or a hen. Or Jake, I can't tell, the grass is so high. Jake, come on. Every time I go to move, they poke up over that little ridge. They'll get down in the dip. Crap. Two turkeys out there. I seen the other one put his head up when I was glassing that one. I don't know. Back to the entrance of this gate. Maybe I can use the wood line to get around on that same dip, because usually they'll move this way inside that dip.
I got two turkeys out in the middle of the field. One is for sure a gobbler. I got up high. I could see his beard. 100% a gobbler. It may be two gobblers. There's two turkeys over there. I don't know. And then I got a hen that just come out into the edge of the field right here, which messed up what I was about to do. I was fixing to go down this edge down here in this dip and get up on this tree where I could see him, because more than likely he's going to move back that way. But that hen is now right in my way. If she'll move over, I'll make a move on him. But he is way out there. I don't know if I can, I'll try to show y'all here. Where'd he go? See, he is way out there. Oh, there's the other turkey. Okay, it's definitely two male birds. So it's either a gobbler and a jake or two gobblers. I don't know where that hen went. Yeah, that may be two gobblers right there. All right. I don't know what to do. I've seen them way up here, and I see them leave the field in that back corner. I'm afraid if I move, I'm gonna spook them. But if I can get back over there, I can 100% get low enough where they can't see me and get all the way around. Right where that hen came from. Have to get down and crawl, I guess. Yeah, I think that's two gobblers. Because they're both big birds. I know one is for sure. I've seen his beard. Alright, time to make a move.
So I got around the field and I got to the edge of this dip where these turkeys like to move to. So I'm just gonna watch them and hopefully I don't even have to call to them. Hopefully they'll just naturally drift this way and get into range here. I am a lot closer than I was to start out with. So.
Coming, but the other one didn't seem too interested. Doesn't look like he is anyway. That other one's facing this direction. From the other gobbler. If he was coming straight this direction.
He got pretty close, but he never did step over into gun range. I may have to use that dip that they're walking back and forth across to get up close to one. Let me see if I can stand up and find them with my binoculars and see where they're at. I may be able to get in this field and make a move on one. I'm gonna have to leave this camera behind though. Too much to carry. Okay, so that was the second turkey that walked away from me. The first one is still right here. I stood up and I could see his back, and then he put his head up and looked. He's just on the other side of this piece of, I don't know, it's like a grass clump or something. It's just where I can't see him. I think he might be in range. It's just hard to tell with this clump of grass in between us.
Someone saw this prize. That's no good for me because I cannot shoot to the right at all. I can shoot straight in front of me and slightly left. I have no shot right. And that's the direction he was pointing, of course. Over this rise somewhere in front of me, and I got another one way out to my left. know how far this one in front of me's gotten. Hopefully he's still in range. Oh, the dropper. Oh, my man. That's probably the most intense turkey hunt I've ever had.
Tell you what, that right there was the most intense turkey hunt I've ever been on. I had two gobblers out here in the middle of this field, and then I had a hen at another level of difficulty. I wanted to go around the direction she come out. She stepped out of the woods right when I was about to make a move. So I had to do the exact opposite. Come down just inside this wood line right here. And I ended up, this is actually pretty clear on the inside of here. And there's a dirt mound right there. Ended up tucking up beside that dirt mound. And them turkeys, they stay in this little dip right here. And they was about, I don't know, 300-400 yards across. I guess they're pressured by the neighbors or something, because never gobbled. Not one time did they gobble. And that the other gobbler that was with him, he looked like he was a little bit bigger, but he wanted no part of the call at all. Oh, man. Oh, tagged out. Tagged out, 2024. Got a decent beard on him. Check these white spurs out. Big pretty turkey.
Tag out. That was a freaking hunt right there. I mean, I had to turn into a regular assassin to get this turkey. They was standing out in the middle of this field. And there's a big swag right in the middle of it.
And usually, if the turkeys are there, they get down in this swag, I can make a move, but they stay just on that opposite side where they can see everything. And I mean, the only choice I had two options. I could go down that wood line, which is what I wanted to do because there's a dip over there that I could just walk and get on the back side of them. As soon as I started heading that way, a hen walked out of the corner and I had to stop. If I busted her, she was gonna run them out of the field. So the only other option I had was to follow the wood line down this way and get at the end of this swag, which ended up working out because there's a little clearing right here inside the woods, so I had a good shot if they would have came closer. But he got to probably 60 yards, and that's as close to the woods as he was coming. Luckily, I had this little hill right here between me and him. When he ducked around this hill, I just crawled up here. And I was trying not to spook that turkey, because he looked like he wanted to come this way. He ended up seeing me, I guess, move or something, crawling around. But I got to the crest of this hill, and I went to stand up, and I seen him duck his head down feet, 30 yards away. So I got back down, crawled a little bit closer. That way I could see all the way over the hill when I stood up. And I got up to my knees, and I guess he heard me or something, so poked his head up, but that's all I needed. Man, what a hunt to end the season. Tagging out.